please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
It's a weak start for the Asian markets this Monday.
I'm very, very optimistic on small caps.
Okay.
Irrespective of macro.
If you are selling on a breakdown or if you're buying on a breakout, this market is punishing you.
Raiko Khaitan, it's been a big mover. It has entered the SEBI's watch list from the start of this month. And since the start of this month, the stock has lost about 15%.
Okay, so the first rate is 8 points in the green for the Nifty, but that's quickly slipping. The Nifty is almost in the red now, 10,814, 10,813.
Cadila Health, that stock saw a 40% rally in the span of few months in 2017, which really bucked the trend in the pharma sector, but fizzled out since.
We are expecting the DOT to give a conditional nod for the Idea Vodafone merger. If not today, then at least sometime this week.
News reports have suggested that ICICI Pru Life CEO Sandeep Bakshi could be looked at by the board as an interim CEO to replace Chanda Kochhar.
16,000 crores is the total amount, and the max buyback price that they're talking about, is around 2,100 rupees on a per share basis.
0.5% cut on the mid cap index. The Nifty and the Sensex percentage-wise are basically flat.
Okay, give and take everything, the bulls should be reasonably happy with the day, considering the kind of start that the SGX Nifty in the morning was indicating. This is closing bell. I'm Anuj, with me is Surabhi. Hi Surabhi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Anuj. Only 40 points, I guess 45 points in the range, but it's been all over, right? I mean, the direction is not even working out for like half an hour today. It's that kind of a day.
Yeah, you know, I think I'll get tired of repeating this, Surabhi. I've been making this point ad nauseum now. This is a market which is going to trap you on both directions. And at times it's going to give you a sign that it's breaking down. At times it's going to give you a sign that it's breaking out. It's doing nothing. And if you see today, today's range has been even lower than Friday's range. It's been a really narrow range. Now, normally, you know, when the markets spend too much time in a narrow range, they break out or break down violently. So that possibility is still there. But right now, you know, today what's really interesting is that the market sort of latched on to crude oil as the bigger play than, you know, what was happening, whether the trade war or emerging market currency weakness. Because if you see, today we've been one of the best performing markets, at least in the emerging market basket. Currency after opening lower has gone up. Mm-hmm. And the profile of stocks which has added today is more of an indication of oil play. So, you know, HPCL, BPCL, all these stocks have done well. Short point is that this is still a range. I think a lot depends on what happens with ICICI Bank in last hour. Because I think the market's now going with this being a bit of a, you know, move towards closure on ICICI Bank or this whole Chanda Kochhar episode, because otherwise, you know, you would have seen this rally being sold into, like has been the case in the past. So obviously at 280 there's buying, but in the past at around 290 there's selling as well. So that I think is really interesting for me. I would also want to see the delivery stats in ICICI Bank today to see if there's been aggressive buying. Of course, that's been compensated by the selling in the stronger ones like HDFC Bank and Kotak. But that, you know, is, you know, just a profit taking. That pocket is still strong and will bounce back. There's a move on the ICICI Bank stock, which I think is quite interesting.
Absolutely. ICICI Bank holding on to those gains of about 3-3.5%. Interestingly, something like an SBI, which at least in the morning was trying to help the bulls case, even that's kind of turned around. And the HDFC twins, as Anuj pointed out, they've been struggling. So Anuj, the point being that I guess today on the index as well, there weren't too many individual stocks also which gave you a very clear trade, barring the OMCs as you mentioned.
Yes.
Even if you went short on an HDFC, I mean, how much money would you have made anyway? So even on a stock-specific basis within the Nifty 50, you didn't have that today.
Yes. Also, you know, one thing which also stands out is, for example, we were discussing Dr. Reddy's. I think that stock is trying to make a move towards the high point of the day rather than lows of the day. And from the low point, there's been quite a bit of buying. So I think one theme which is still standing out is people are still looking to buy these pharma stocks on declines. But otherwise, absolutely, there's no trend as such. It's just that you have to play the boundaries.
Okay, well, we've got an hour left this Monday afternoon. Let's get started and tell you what's lined up on the show. We will get you excerpts of the exclusive conversation that Anuj had with market veteran Shankar Sharma, his next big call, and of course, the sectors that he is bullish on. We discuss all of that. Of course, market and top stock ideas coming up with Kamlesh Kotak, head of research at AMSEC. We will discuss market fundamentals as always with Mr. SP Tulsian of sptulsian.com, also Deepak Shenoy of Capital Mind and Mayuresh Joshi of Angel Broking. But first up, as always, some technical advice on what to do, the trades you can play. We have Prakash Gaba and Mitesh Thakkar for that.
In fact, let's start with that then, because the market's been in a very narrow range. The Bank Nifty, as we speak, is now once again trying to move out of that on the upside. Just pull out that intraday chart on that. Prakash and Mitesh with us for that. Good afternoon. Mitesh, your thoughts on this narrow range, and what does that mean for last hour and for positional traders?
Afternoon, Anuj. I think, you know, what's happened in the last few days is that we've seen a lot of indicators which show trend and force, I think, are flattening out. So very clearly, my sense is that this range might extend for a day or two. Last week, on Thursday, we had a gap down with a pivot at 10,850. So that's the upper end of the range. 10,770, 775 is the lower end of the range. I think a break on either side could give you additional bias. Till then, it remains more of a stock-specific kind of a trading environment. I have one buy, which is on Piramal Enterprises with a stop at 2480 for targets of 2630. And Mindtree is a conditional sell. If it breaks 980, go short with a stop at 995. Look for targets of 950.
Okay, so got a buy and a sell there from Mitesh. Prakash, good afternoon. Again, it's been tough. I mean, to even find stocks which give you a very clear trade and trend since the morning. But what are the, your bets that you're going with now?
Absolutely a bad day today, to must say that. Very tight range. So far, I would say that Bank Nifty is still weak. It's not strong. Even if it does go up, it's likely to get find some struggle zone between 26,510 to 26,518,600 zones. That's a tough area to cross-negotiate with. But Bank Nifty now, if it crosses around 10,830, you can see a good jump to around 10,875. So there's a good chance if Nifty gets a breakout, then it can go up. But Bank Nifty is likely to find some resistance. We need to stay stock-specific. Two stocks look good to me. One is Power Grid, still looking strong to me. Looks like it's holding out. Can climb to levels closer to 202 zones, stop below 198. And second is Shriram Transport. Looks like it's climbing to levels closer to 1505, stop below 1470.
Okay, by the way, some of the erstwhile favorites are making a bit of a comeback. And the name that really stands out now is TVS Motor. You see the intraday chart on that one. TVS Motor, of course, after the results, corrected quite a bit, but now that stock, look at that move. Actually, it's quite, I think after a long time, it's crossed 600, 602 is what we have on TVS Motor. Let's just pull out a slightly longer chart of the stock because, you know, it's a bit of a breakout that we can sense here. Still down, of course, 22% for the year, and that's the 6-month chart. Still quite a bit of correction. But from the highs of 786, it's fallen quite a bit. SP Tulsian of sptulsian.com and Deepak Shinai of Capital Mind with us. Good afternoon. Mr. Tulsian, first, your thoughts on TVS, since that's the fresh breakout of the moment. It spent quite a bit of time here. You reckon it's a good value here?
Anuj, you're talking about TVS Motor?
Yes, Mr. Tulsian.
Yes, I think that, in fact, we have been, you know, keeping positive view on this stock maybe for last about 18 months or so, and when it moved to 750 past that, you know, it has really become an expensive stock. But after having corrected in this last maybe 3-4 months, I think this has been giving a good buying opportunity. And even at the current level of 600 rupees, in fact, I think in my couple of shows in the last 1 week, I've said that this is a very good buy at 570, 575. Because there has been no complaint in respect to the sales growth which we have been seeing, you know, in comparison to the peers. And the stock having corrected from close to about 780, 790 to the sub 600 level was definitely making it a good buy. And I think that even from the current level, the stock has good upside. I don't think that the downside is seen from here, because even Q1 numbers, the only red flag for the stock is seen to be the Q1 numbers, because always market expects to expects the company to report very high margin, which is not possible because companies focusing more on retaining its market shares and, you know, keep seeing the new products introduction and all that. But it's still taking that into account. I think the ahead of the Q1 numbers, you can still see an upside of maybe about 8-9% from here, expecting a level of 645 to 650 in the share price.
Okay, that's a call on TVS Motors. By the way, another stock on the move right now, we don't usually talk about it, DCM Shriram. That buyback price is handsome, what the company is offering. Stock's trading at 315, 316. They're offering 450, maximum price of 450. The last time the shares were at that level was almost a month back, and there was a severe, brutal fall along with a lot of the other sugar stocks as well. So if you pull up a 1 year, you'll see the price damage that happened in the last 5 weeks or so during the mid-cap sell-off. And now a buyback has come back. All right, let's bring in Deepak Shenoy into the conversation as well. Afternoon, Deepak. Pharma have to talk to you about Pharma. What else? You know, even today, after sustained 7-8 days of buying, a stock like Strides Shasun is jumping away 4-5% higher. Buying coming back already, as Anu was highlighting earlier. Would you buy anything fresh after the rally that we've already seen?
Surabhi, I think we've been invested in Pharma, and having been beaten up for a while, I think I've been invested in Strides as well. Some of the problems that were existing in the system continue to exist. They're just going away piece by piece. We've seen Sun Pharma getting some kind of a reprieve with Halol. We don't know how much that's going to impact the stock yet in terms of financial performance, but obviously it's starting to move. There's also Strides. I think there's not been much news yet, but primarily here there's a consolidation happening under Arun Kumar, who has returned, and hopefully there is some kind of respite in terms of results, but I don't expect anything for another 2 quarters. Having said that, prices on pharma are moving up across the board, and we are really considering whether this is the time to pick up a basket and then find out which are the winners that eventually sustain and then go on with them. So it may be better to take an approach of buying a basket today, small amounts, and then pushing it further.
Fair enough. Perhaps buy a basket instead of a stock in the pharma space. Mr. Tulsian, thoughts on Adani Green? It's done volumes of 70 lakhs as we speak. Of course, for today, it's locked on 5% upper circuit. That's the maximum it can do today. But it's interesting because the opening was around 28.5, and now it's on upper freezer 31.5. Your thoughts on the stock?
I don't think that the business model is really seen quite exciting, in spite of the ambitious plans having given by the management and all that. So looking to the end, in fact, with this view was given by me when it got hived off from the Adani Enterprise, that the maximum value seen, continuing with the existing stock and this listed stock recently. In fact, I was expecting it to list at around 25 rupees in the morning. I've said this on Awaaz, that the expected listing price may be at about 25, 26 rupees. So I think that those who have been holding it, because the stock will remain in trade to trade for a couple of weeks, and probably you may see this kind of upper circuit, and then, I won't be surprised to see it correcting also. So one should not get too greedy. Those who have got the stock on restructuring of Adani Enterprise, and at least I'll advise to exit, use this upper circuit either today or tomorrow to exit from the stock.
Mitesh, what's with the OMC trade now? Pretty decent moves, IOC, HPCL, etc. And these stocks are off some 15-16% off their 52-week low. So there's some bounce that's kind of happened. Is this just a flash in the pan? Will it wither away, or do you think someone can ride this maybe for a couple of days?
My sense is that we might be able to ride it for a couple of days. It goes with the disclaimer that we have recommended a couple of them to our clients as well. So HPCL, my sense is that I think this stock possibly is heading towards levels close to about 350, 360 on the upside. Similarly, BPCL also, I think, has given some kind of a positive crossover on the indicator setup. So would look at target of around 455 over here. And for both these stocks, I would take about roughly 2.5-3% kind of a stop loss from current levels.
Fair enough. I think we now need to spend some time on ICICI Bank, because this really is going to be perhaps the story of the day, if indeed it comes out. The board meeting, of course, is underway, so we'll find out. But in the past, there have been 3 or 4 occasions, Surabhi, when this news flow has come around, and only to find out that it flatters to deceive. So this time around,
but Anuj, could it be different this time? I know it's within the realm of speculation right now, but there's a name that's doing the rounds.
Yes.
And our colleague Ritu is also talking about the fact that there is a lot of discussion around this name. Today evening we'll probably know whether there's any truth to it, or whether it's just far from reality at the moment. Maybe that's why the market's taking it with a little more conviction this time around.
Perhaps it is, but my only worry is that if that was the case, you would have seen huge volumes. And right now, that I think is not the indication that I'm getting looking at the screen. But yes, for now, when it's doing well, we'll go across to Ritu as well. But Mr. Tulsian, your thoughts? We discussed this in the morning. Is this now a value buy? Is this now a matter of time before Chanda Kochar moves on, and the market then talks about the fundamentals, the book value, and the fact that it's one of the cheapest stocks?
That's right, Arjun. That was the view. In fact, I've expressed in the morning also, and maybe have been giving the same view, when we have seen the stock correcting from the level of 295 to 280 also. And in fact, if you see the delivery volume of the Friday also, that has been phenomenal, over 3 crore shares, you know, or maybe 3.5, closer to 3.5 crore shares. Having seen the delivery volume, is seen that, you know, probably the strong hands are seen accumulating the stock. And in fact, if you really take a call, this is what I have said, that the replacement of Chanda Kochar is seen imminent now, and that may happen any time. You know, maybe it's a matter of whether it happens by interim CEO or the regular one. That's a matter of different, you know, that's a matter of for the board to take a call. But all these negatives are seen behind, and if you really take a call on the stock, like, or maybe, because ICICI Bank should not only be taken as a bank in isolation. In fact, this is an institution, you know, having the interest in insurance and, you know, maybe the capital market activities and all sort of things, combination of all. And I think that this is seen to have a very good value, and we have been giving a price target of maybe 330 to 340, you know, maybe next 1 month or so, once this all news flows, you know, comes into the place. Because I think the inquiry by the retired Supreme Court judge is seen behind, that will take its own time, maybe 3-4 months. Or maybe more than that, and I don't think that will really be discussed now as a negative for the stock, because people will start take the call on the future working going up once the new CEO comes in. So all the positives are seen only lined up now, with no negatives or all the negatives seen behind.
Sure, let's take this forward then with our colleague Ritu, who has a busy evening, I think, lined up ahead of her. Ritu, there's a board meet underway. And, you know, I guess the point that Mr. Tulsian is making as well is that if the board is actually going to ratify the appointment of a very senior Supreme Court judge to look into allegations of impropriety, you know, with respect to the MD and CEO, then maybe the board also will need to consider an interim CEO.
Absolutely, Surbhi. You know, in fact, we managed to have a word with Mr. Shri Krishna also earlier. While he did confirm that he was appointed, that ratification has to come from the board today. He did say that the entire process, where lawyers, you know, forensic auditors will be appointed, that process could take 6 to 8 weeks or more. So in the meantime, yes, sir, perhaps there is a need for the appointment of an interim CEO, because, you know, we do understand that Chanda Kochar proceeded on leave at the end of May, and 1st of June is when the bank informed the exchanges that she was on her annual leave. From what we understand, she was supposed to resume this week itself, but she hasn't joined back. So this board meeting today is coming amidst all of these allegations, and we do understand that there are two things on the agenda. One, of course, is the ratification of Justice Sri Krishna to head that independent probe committee, where he will be supported by Uday Chitale, who's the head of the audit committee at ICICI Bank. The second thing is the fate of Chanda Kochar, whether or not she should be asked to proceed on an indefinite leave until the probe results are in, and whether it merits the appointment of an interim CEO. There are new reports in the papers today that said that Sandeep Bakshi is being considered, who's currently the head of ICICI Pru. We also had a word with Mr. Bakshi this morning, and you know, when we asked him about whether he'd heard from the board yet, he said he was not aware of such, you know, any such development, and that he would, of course, you know, be intimated only once the board formally signs on such a, you know, appointment, if at all. So that board meeting is currently underway, the results of which will be keenly watched, because that will decide whether or not Chanda Kochar stays as MD and CEO.
Oh, yes. For now, of course, the market wants to believe that something today is perhaps going to be a bit different, and that's why the stock's still holding on, about 3.5% higher. We'll take a break on that note. Up next, we'll be back with Kamlesh Kotak, Head of Research at MSEC Securities, to discuss the market and some stock ideas.
Welcome back. Rangebound is the only way of describing this market. It is absolutely not giving any indication of which way it wants to go in. 1 point up on the Nifty. That's what it's all about. Sandeep Wagle is with us. Sandeep, have you managed to find some interesting stocks to trade?
Afternoon, Surbhi. I think there are stock-specific opportunities. I would go long in Jubilant Foods, stop loss of 27.55, target of 28.32, and a sell in a Sun TV, stop loss of 8.93, target 8.70.
Okay, one buy and one sell. Sandeep, thanks a lot for those trading ideas. By the way, this just, you know, keep an eye on the cement pack, because through the morning, some of these stocks were making lows of the day, and now a couple of them are making highs of the day. A case in point is Shree Cement. Just see the intraday chart of Shree Cement. That's, of course, ACC. That one also has bounced back quite a bit from the low point. That is Shree Cement. From the lows, there's quite a bit of recovery. And the other is India Cement. That also, from the lows, is making quite a bit of high. In fact, you've seen that in a couple of others as well. Pull out others like Ultratech, Ambuja, Dalmia Bharat. So at lower level, obviously, there's some bit of buying that is visible. Deepak, I wanted your thoughts on the cement space. You know, stocks are close to 52-week lows, but you reckon it's closer to the end of the cycle?
Actually, I don't. I think still that, you know, we're in an early phase of, you know, correction in cement stocks. I largely believe that I think a lot of cement expectations are very, very high. So a lot of the stocks have run up substantially. I mean, from the ACC and Ambuja's, even the Ultratechs, I think extreme valuations have been given. They've reached a point where I think the market is not growing more than maybe 9 to 11%, and you know, we have substantially higher price to earning ratios, and also we don't see the kind of growth that will kind of meet these numbers on cement as a whole. I would focus on smaller geographically specific plays where infrastructure assessment will probably override any short-term cycle changes. So I can't take names right now because we're buying a few players in the space, but I'd say small and geographically isolated is probably a much better play than the broad larger players.
Mr. Tulsian, before we thank you today, your thoughts on the other large bank, HDFC Bank. They'll soon be undergoing a pretty big fundraising exercise as well now that the clearance is in place. The stock is still off about 5-6% this month. What would your advice be here?
See, we have been keeping positive view, in fact, on all the larger PSU, larger private sector banks. And in fact, if you really see, the more they raise the capital, more the growth, the banks will keep posting them. And in fact, I think this capital raising will be the continuous exercise, whether you talk of HDFC Bank, IndusInd Bank, Yes Bank, or maybe, you know, in fact, Kotak has not been that aggressive in raising the capital. But in fact, that's a lifeline. And the kind of major portion or the share of the PSU bank is being taken by these private sector banks is likely to see continuing. Maybe the advance tax numbers of all the banks have not been seen for the Q1, because Q1 and Q4 installments are always the indications for the banks to, or for any company to take a call based on their advance tax payments. So we have been keeping positive view. In fact, the best part is that in this last 10 days, the private sector banks have all consolidated and corrected. And maybe, you know, barring RBL Bank or these kind of banks, you know, the rest all have corrected. So I think one should really enter into the stocks when they remain, they lie low, or they have not seen a big participation. But we have been keeping positively, because they, again, the Q1 numbers will from all these banks will really be quite rewarding and quite cheerful. So keeping all the positive view on the larger PSU, larger private sector bank. Apart from that, even keeping positive view on the smaller one, or maybe the smaller one private sector banks also, like Federal Bank or Karnataka Bank.
Okay, Mr. Sian, you know, just one more question actually. You know, today we had a news report that government might be looking to sell some stake in Coal India. The stock fell, but after that has recovered as well immediately. Your thoughts on the stock?
Sianuj, I don't know whether that will be reduction to the 75% stake to bring down, because I think that right now the Coal India government stake is closer to about 79%. And if you, whether the government will be pruning it down to 75%, or that will be a fund mobilization exercise as a divestment. But I think that in both the situation, things will not be taken very well by the market. And I keep a little softer view on the stocks, because the kind of performance which has been shown by the PSU banks, maybe in this offer for sale also by on the stock exchanges and all that, or maybe, you know, to trim the shareholding, has not been very rewarding. And going forward, I'm not taking the Q4 numbers. The numbers have been optically disappointed, but post management clarification, if you really take the FY18 over FY17 also, there has been disappointment. And in fact, people are talking of this 40,000-45,000 cash, but that is a wrong way of looking at it in Coal India. In fact, the cash, because if the net worth is 20,000 crore, and if you have 40,000-45,000 crore cash, that is towards meeting your other liabilities. So I don't think that on any front, whether if I take an EPS or estimate of about 13-14 rupees for FY19, or maybe on the book value parameters, I don't think that the stock has any potential. And maybe even if the trimming happens to 75% stake sale by about 3-3.5%, by which government can mobilize 5,000 crore, I think that will also not be going well with the market.
All right. Thanks, Mr. Tulsian, very much for joining us on the show today. We will connect with you again tomorrow. Well, on that note, let's move on and welcome in our next guest. We have Kamlesh Kotak, Head of Research at AMSEC, joining us to talk about their take on earnings, the market, and of course some interesting stock ideas that they're working with at the moment. Thanks, Kamlesh, so much for being with us. You know, I'm going to start off with first what you're recommending on a lot of the consumption stocks, poster boys of the market anyway. Even on a day like today, I mean, you're seeing the buying in Dabur, you're seeing the buying in Jubilant, in something like a Bata. Arvind is sort of slightly higher. Despite high valuations, would you still recommend entering? And what sort of consumption stocks would you back?
Good afternoon. So just to capture, say, what has been now playing out for the market is the infrastructure, engineering, capital goods sector per se, if you see over the last couple of months has shown some sort of weakness. And that is rightly so because we are heading towards a very busy election season. And typically government oriented businesses would not be that great in terms of playing the market in this sort of thing. Plus, we also are seeing the rising interest rate scenario that is also going to play not favorably for those sectors. In that scenario, people are comfortable with consumer-facing business, and that is where even valuations are high. But because the growth visibility is pretty strong, they don't have any leverage or baggage in terms of the high debt, which is where the stocks are holding very well. And I think that should play out even over the next 2-3 quarters is what we believe, till some clarity emerges on the overall scenario as far as the political front goes. So we also are positive on consumption theme rather than the infrastructure, engineering, capital goods theme at this point in time.
Okay, Kamlesh, hi, good afternoon. So on the mid-cap space, what are the broad themes to work with? Or you think this year is where you would rather focus on large caps and the kind of fall that we've seen in mid-caps could accentuate?
I don't see there is any particular reason to look at only large cap per se. Even mid caps have got quite a good number of stories which are playing very well. There are players in sectors across consumer appliances, automotive, chemicals, which are looking good. So I think there would be a mix of large cap and mid cap. The idea is to look at the underlying business, how the company's strength in terms of the market positioning, the balance sheet, and I think overall comfort in terms of the long-term sustainability of growth is what will play out. So I think even some of the mid-caps also we are liking at this point in time. Maybe the valuations may have stretched up, but en route we are expecting that there will be enough of buying opportunities. One should zero down on those stocks and get into them at the right price point is what should be the strategy.
Okay. I just want to talk about a couple of the stocks that you seem to have a conviction on. One of them is VIP Industries. So, you know, what's the call here? What's the thesis?
Yeah. So the stock has done very well over the last couple of years. If you see, the background of that would be twofold. One is, as you see, that all the tourism and travel-related business are doing extremely well. You look at the aviation traffic growth, you look at the railway traffic growth, you see the hospitality and auto industry occupancy level, they all have been pointing to buoyant times. VIP has got the strongest, it's a leadership position in terms of the luggage industry. Their two core brands, the VIP and soft bag luggage, that is Skybag, is doing extremely well. They have been growing market share with the players more getting into formalized economy. What also has helped them is the last year there has been stunning growth in terms of both their top line and bottom line. The margin have expanded. Their other two brands like the backpack category and Capri, the women's purse category, also are doing a 23% plus growth. So overall the macro environment is good in terms of the growth of travel tourism sector. The company's strong brands and aggressive marketing strategy are working well for them. It has grown 32% earning CAGR over the last 5 years. And the management is guiding of similar growth going to be there over the next 3 to 5 years. Now, I only have to highlight one thing, that you don't have to extrapolate the strong margin of the 4Q. In the coming quarter, there may be some softening of margin because of the INR depreciation and the crude prices going higher. Mm-hmm. However, no, long-term structural story remains very much strong. Any decline should be considered as a buying opportunity. The stock is around 39 and 33 times next 2 years earning. But we are extremely positive on the long-term structural growth story, and that is where we recommend the stock as a good long-term story to buy.
Okay, by the way, just keep an eye on a couple of stocks flashing on the screen. Balrampur Chini is really interesting. That's coming off the low point. The sugar prices, of course, have hit. In fact, 2 days back, there was a big surge in sugar prices, and that's the reason that despite the sector being in a bit of a doldrum, of late, there's been quite a bit of recovery in some of these stocks, and today also, you're seeing that play out. Kamlesh, the other stock that I want to talk to you about is Sundaram Fasteners, because a lot of stocks in this space which have done well. Why do you like Sundaram in particular?
Well, this is again a very strong company from the TVS Group, has been in the business for more than 50 years. From the leadership position of high tensile fasteners, the company has emerged as a global player with a vast product portfolio. They make cold extruded parts, hot roach parts. They also make the radiator caps and also powertrain and pump equipment that goes into entire automotive, from two-wheeler to construction equipment, passenger vehicles and commercial vehicles. Now, what is good about the company is that it could successfully deliver on their export market as well, with 34% of their revenue coming from exports. Their two subsidiaries, both in UK and China, also have turned around over the last 3 to 5 years. Domestically, they have been doing extremely well with all the marquee names as their customers. Going forward, as you see, the commercial vehicle, tractor, infrastructure doing well. Both their automotive and non-automotive business should show a strong growth. The weakening of INR will further strengthen their export business. One niche thing about the company is they have a very high focus on capability in terms of product portfolio expansion and research and development, which is helping them getting more and more products under its belt. So I think it's a play on industrial, infrastructure, automotive across the player and exports. We expect at least 20 to 22% earning CAGR going to be there even for the coming years. It's a very strong and stable, sound investment for someone looking at a consumer-facing business with 2 to 3 years perspective.
Hmm. And finally, Kamlesh, one more stock. It's an interesting one, slightly complicated business, of course. Apcotex Industries. It's specialty rubber, perhaps, that's a segment that it looks at. Again, you know, what's the upside and, what's your call here?
Yeah. So this is a very unique company which specializes into emulsion polymer, or you can say rubber polymer chemicals. The company has got three products: high styrene rubber that goes into footwear application. They are also having latexes, which goes into various applications like construction, waterproofing, carpets, tires, textiles, and all those sectors. Paper also is one of them. The third is nitrile butadiene rubber, which is a niche technology they got acquired with a company they acquired in 2016. So around 15% coming from HSR, 50% revenue comes from the latex, and 35% from the NBR business. The company last year reported very strong numbers, with all the integration of the newly acquired businesses now being completed. They are in the middle of very strong expansion because they face capacity constraint. Export last year grew 100% for them, and it is currently around 15-18% of the revenue. Going forward, they have got a huge pipeline of new technology. Some of them are monopoly products and with global marketplace. So they have been very strongly poised to grow these businesses, not only in India, but also in overseas markets. With the kind of a monopolistic situation, the technological age, and global acceptability of the market products, I think the company would be in a unique position to grow even from here on. So we expect at least 40% earnings CAGR for the company over the next 3 to 4 years, which is where we like the company's business. Stock is also trading attractive at around 14-15 times FY20. So I think this is one of the good chemical business, as we see, with a global market opportunity one should look at. It's a small cap stock, but I think long-term investor definitely would see a rewarding return coming from this stock.
Okay, Kamlesh, we leave it there today. Thanks a lot for joining us today. That's the view from Hamsec Securities. We'll take a break. Up next, we'll get you the BDST course, Buy Today, Sell Tomorrow, from our technical experts.
And as always, it's Monday, which means it'll be time for Midcap Mania. We'll see which midcap companies on Nigel's radar.
No one wants their world record to be broken. But I know there will be another. And that's the way it should be. Because good enough will never change the world. Yeah.